Hello, I'm Dr. Eliya Kostova, and today I want to represent you the invisible reality of human body. Invisible reality of human body starts with understanding of the field structure of our universe. The main point of this presentation is how to connect the universal knowledge with the structure of the human body. So actually, what is the meaning of the terms ether, field, and space? Ether is the dielectric inertia where everything exists. This is the soup of fields. And what is actually field? Field, that is expression of ether. This is the simple structure inside of the ether, and how ether represents itself. And space actually exists only when exists the fields, because fields terminate as space. I follow the work of different scientific people, and the last years I follow the work of Ken Wheeler. So how he explained all this fundamental knowledge of everything what I said as ether, field, and space, he defined the fundamental field modalities also. This is the magnetism, what is the coherent special force, electricity, the electricity and gravity, what is the incoherent contraspecial magnetism, actually opposite of magnetism. This is the fundamental field modalities, what we see, not only how it organizes our universe and the life in our planet. On the same way, everything is built on the base of these main laws. All these laws have several principles, and I will not go deep inside of them. You are able to find the work of Ken Wheeler, and I will leave you the links below the video. But mostly, it is crucial to understand how the different shape and forms form not only in the field matter or also in the material world. So most important is to know the vector equilibrium, what is the main plane of all the life, and everything what is placed on that plane is the living being, have a life inside. That is actually the plane of inertia. Everything is happen on that plane. And the inertia plane contact with the magnetical torus and hyperbola of the dielectricity. And they form the specific geometrical shapes, what we call actually after time, we call it the sacral geometry. And the principles are several. This is like inertia. What is the meaning of inertia? This is the tendency of stillness to remain in charge, to be not potential, to have any motion. And then we have acceleration, force and motion, charge and discharge, spatial and contraspatial, centrifugal, creation of polarity and creation of spin, capacitance, resistance, and so on. So on the right side of the slide, you're able to see explanation in the images of those forces. In the middle, this is the plane of inertia, and centrifugal vectors of the electricity, and centrifugal way of the magnetism, in centripetal way of the electricity. This is actually important to understand because of all this organization of field, we get the specific shapes. Actually, of centrifugal way of magnetism, we have a shape of torus, and in the middle forms the hyperbola. How you see, this is the hourglass shape where the forces come centripetal, from outside to inside, from outside to inside. And when we have combination of centripetal and centrifugal way of motion of the field, we gain the spin. And then when we have the combination of those two motions, we actually start to have a living bank. And here I want to represent you one visualization of the Harvey Riney, how he used the software to develop and to try to explain how forms the magnetism and how regarding the spin in different durations, if you actually get the different shape and form. That is the completely way to show how the electricity goes and how the form, the magnetic torus and the electrical hyperbola inside of every shape. So regarding that, we gain the different configurations of the field in space, and because of that, we get the different platonic solids. All those different platonic solids, there's the base, how the matter level in our planet forms. In the next slide, I want to represent you the last update, how the scientific astronomers show our galaxy and how the Higgs ray chimneys connect to the Milky Way in the mysterious bubbles of the gamma ray. And the last video of Ken Wheeler, he so nicely represent actually how the shape of the galaxy and the Higgs ray chimney actually represent everything what I tell you in advance. This is the inertia plane, where is the our galaxy. The forces would come to the galaxy from outside to in. This is the centripetal dielectric plant. And everything what is go outside, this is the centrifugal magnetical part. Actually, magnetical part here is a representation of magnetical torus, but just in cross section. It means that the torus is opposite shape of hyperbolic dielectric shape. And how you see on the next picture, this is so famous picture of the theory of discharge of fields. And it is representation again of the hyperbolic dielectric centripetal forces and the magnetic centrifugal forces. So in the middle is how we call in the standard physics equal vector equilibrium, or this is the inertia plane. And in the middle, this is contra spatial regarding the opposite, what is the magnetism. This is the spatial part of the forces. It means everything what is move make the space and also make the time, because time cannot exist if you don't have a magnitude. Everything what we see in the galaxy, in the shape of galaxy, is how the fields and forces and principles and modalities explain themselves in the formation of galaxies. We can see information in our body also. How you see the plan of inertia is in here, and it's so close the formation of the electromagnetical field of our heart, and how we know the electromagnetic field of our heart is the bigger one in our body. So from there, we have the electrical part, what forces come inside of our body from above and from below, and they connect in inertia part or in the vectorum equilibrium. And then start the formation of centrifugal magnetical forces, what actually in our body they represent itself in our upper and lower limbs. So as above, as below. In the next slide, it's a representation how electromagnetical field in the name of human biofield current go inside of our body. And already we know from Indian science, from traditional Chinese medicine, that we have not only the blood and lymph vessels, but we already know that we have and meridian vessels, and they've been already proven in Japanese laboratories. So actually on that part we see how the magnetical force represent itself on the flow of current in our body. The inner part what connects all the channels in the central way of our body, this is a representation of the electrical forces what have a centripetal duration. And actually, what we call the chakras or the wheels, this is the transformational centers where fields gain or stop to gain different velocity. So this is the representation of nadis, and how you know we have different channels, we have left and right pinna, and the central sushumna. This is the dielectrical part of our biosystem, biocurrent system. And because of the centripetal flow and gain of inertia, afterwards is this formation of magnetical part, what is present in our body of formation of the bubble is around the human body. And that we call aura, or this is the electromagnetical bubble around our body. The same manifestation in the matter level, we are able to see as a egg around the embryo. What is the actually many tissues where they form the bubble where the human embryo sits inside the womb. In the electromagnetical spectrum, we have also the magnetical bubble. The representation of the same things, this is the work of the heart. And heart actually have an autonomic system, nervous system, what represent the formation again of the dielectrical and magnetical part, and have the inertia part here, and all the devices what are able to connect and to register the rhythm of the heart is based exactly of the field knowledge. So actually what we are able to say that we have the fragmentation of the reality. The reality represents itself in the same model as in universe, that in our body, up to the cells. So we have the same representation of inertia plant, the dielectricity and the magnetical torus as holographic fractals one by one, from big one to the small one, from the big aura of our biomagnetical field to the biomagnetical field of the cell. And then we go further in our investigation. Just a second. Okay. So we may say that in the words what we use in our century now, we represent ether. So we say that ether is the soup of fields. And these fields start to represent themselves with different modalities and principles. And actually, in the way how they represent themselves, how they protubiate in reality regarding the mediator what they have, they start to express themselves as a consciousness. And then they slow down their velocity to the toes. And then they slow down their velocity to the sound. And then to the light. And then to the color. And finally, we're able to see in our visible reality the material life. But actually, everything what we see in the small window of the visible reality for us. But that is not mean that we are only that visible reality. We are go up to the order that we are able to represent ourselves like a color, also as a light, also as a sound, also as a thought, as consciousness, and actually as an ether, like a soup of fields. This is a representation of the geometry of consciousness, what is made by John Benjamin Betz in 19th century. So you see the same representation of the geometrical shapes as hyperbolas and torus. But actually, this is what we spoke in advance, that the consciousness is just slow down of the velocity of the field, and they starts to make a geometrical shape. What is the actually the sacral geometry? And then when you form your consciousness after the investigation of that, then Stanley Kahneman proven that regarding the shape of your consciousness, you are able to form the shape of your body. So on that way, it is mean that everything is determined, but follow one line, we finally, through the consciousness, through thoughts, we reaching the material level. Our system, our body, we can represent of several of organizations of organs in systems, and actually that organization of part of the organ represent the formation of the toroidal and the formation of electromagnetical field in the part of our body. Our body have one big electromagnetical field, but as I told you, we are representation of the electromagnetical fields from the cell. And then most of the cells, but they have simple function, equal function, they make an organ, so that organ have the electromagnetical field and shape, and then the combination of organs make the systems, and also they place on the several level of our body, what is mean they need the certain velocity of the field, the certain energy, what we say. And actually that is the part where the chakras come. This is the transformation of the velocity. They slow down the speed to the part of the body what is needed to material level on that part of the body to form and to work in proper manner. But this is for to explain everything in three places, we need so much time. So probably about the energy anatomy of the systems, the organs, we need to speak more in different time. So we say that the consciousness and thoughts and then the velocity slow down to the sound. And actually, our DNA is made to resist, to react, to accept and to send the signals, because the shape of our DNA is like a chromatin, and it's already made several investigations about that on Professor Garayev. This is the Russian scientist who make the devices who they're able to catch the sound from the DNA and to see the certain diseases, and then transform the signal in the lasers and use that for the healing of different diseases and processes in the body. So our body have so many structures inside. What we analyze them, and we are able to see that we are able to not only accept ourselves like a material body, but also like a sound, like a light, like a thought, and like a consciousness, because we are a combination of all those terms. This is actually one thing, just the difference is the velocity of the fields. On the next slide, you are able to see when you use the vector math, how you are able to analyze and to calculate the differences in the DNA, how accept the sound, and what actually the frequency it's able to produce. And also we know that all the sound and the frequency, they emerge with color, and each color have the specific sound frequency. But regarding the emotional level, they represent our emotional state. What is mean that emotion is also, it is like a vibrant field of our expressions. That's why many different cultures say that emotions, this is the fuel of our wish. With emotions, we are able to energize the certain thoughts. This is the electromagnetic spectrum. And on that chart, you see that even the tones, they have colors, and they represent different dimensional levels, and they are related to chakras. And the most important thing is that we accept the reality in visible light. This is a so small window where with our senses we are able to catch what is going on. No, but actually reality is not only visible light, and most of the things is happen out of this window. And my research was based on that, how to see what is happening out of the window, and how we, like banks, are able to sustain out of this window. If I'm able to see the human as a color, or if I'm able to see the human just a sound or just a field, and how in our now available devices and tools were able to see out of the window. So Rudolf Virchow is so famous biologist, and he said that the human body is made up of huge number of tiny living cells, each of which is made up of infinitesimal but perfectly balanced amount of three classes of materials. This is water, organic matter, and inorganic matter. Water and organic matter make up the majority of body. However, inorganic mineral elements, although present in much smaller quantities, are really vital elements, active workers who use inactive substances to build the millions of cells that make up the body. Why I say that? Because Before time is proven that more essential tissue salt, or how Biofield said, mineral element 27 of our body, is our building blocks. So I make the calculations of all the 27 tissue salts, and with so big surprise saw that the electromagnetic spectrum of life is microwave. So it's, we appear visible in visible light, but actually our elements belongs to the microwave spectrum of electromagnetic spectrum. So it means that we are not only presented in the visible light, but we are starts to be presented in the microwave length of light. I make the experiment to put inside of silicon the tissue cells. This is example of gallium sulfate. And gallium sulfate starts to grow and cell and to make a crystals. See how beautiful they are. This is the microscope, normal microscopy, and this is the electron microscopy. Actually, is representation how the structure, what input inside of the silicon starts to be like a fish hooker for the fields from a Bormann. And how we know the similar attract the similar. So the similar field starts to attract itself, the similar field from the ether, and starts to grow the crystals itself. So that means that in ether represents all the fields. All the fields exist in the ether. It's up to the fish, the fisher catcher, what kind of fish will catch in it, what kind of fields will attract in it, and to form the material level. This is the natrium sulfate. Again, this is the microscopy, this is the electron microscopy, and the crystal grow itself. I want to show you one video. This is a representation of Brazil, Universal One by Walter Brazil. How from station. And you're able to see that actually the shape of something, this is like a fisher catcher. And the field catching size and starts to form different shapes regarding the sacral geometry, regarding the platonic solid, what I showed you above. It's already proven that mostly of the things what presented in our planet, they are from carbon nanotubes, and mostly for carbon-60. That is the shape of carbon-60 and how it looks like. And this is the electron microscopy of the nanotubes. So I asked myself, if I'm able to find the same structure in our body, even in the normal anatomy of human body. And the answer is yes. So we are able to see and to find the structure blocks in the bones. Bones is made from nanotubules. And because of electron microscopy, we are able now to see that the bones is made from nanotubules. Also your skin, this is a representation of the nanotubule structure of your skin. And because we are living beings in our planet, so it means that we are made from carbon-60 nanotubules too. This is the representation of nanotubes in our muscles. And how we see the same nanotubes with different penetrations. So if we ask ourselves, okay, this is the material level, but how we know that material level represent the field materialization? So it means that if we analyze our magnetic field, we're supposed to find the similar expression of the field modalities. So I want to show you the video what I made. Just 1 second. Yes, this is a representation of the Kirlian photography of the biofield from the finger. Made the picture is made of Tesla bio digital bioelectrography. Most of us, you are familiar with the Kirlian photography. So what is happen what when I start to filtering the digital imaging? So see how in the beginning we spoke about the dielectrical part, magnetical part, the plane of inertia and magnetical array from the body or the shapes. Now in the Kirlian photography, you see the same things, the formation of the inner corona and outer corona. And then you have the magnetical array from this part. And when I start to analyze how I'm able to differentiate if we have kind of diseases or not, actually the outer corona represents the outer corona here, how we see, is a representation of the magnetical part. This is the arrays. But actually for all the body, this is the aura. And see how on the particular part have broken sequences and then arrays is different. And then inner dark things is actually the dielectrical part. And I start to filtering and to make analyzation. If we're able from Kirlianic, what is representation of our magnetical and the electrical field, to find out how it's made our body. If I'm able to find out the same tubular structures in our current, that is mean that we are actually made of nanotubes, and how these nanotubes are able to catch electromagnetic light fields, what I show you in advance. So here you're able to see, I just did different kind of filtrations and starts to appear. This is the magnetic array, you see, on this part and on this part. And then I go deeper and deeper, and finally starts to appear different kind of structures. You see on this part, this is the inner part, what is the dielectrical part, or around the magnetical part from the different kind of shapes. Inside finally appeared these magnetic tubular structures, and how you see they have a different fenestrations, different shapes. What is mean that how we spoke the different fish catcher catch the different fields. And actually when I put the coloring, it's representation of different color. So it mean that those tubes catch the specific light length. This is so important picture where this is the formation of different kind of waves. And actually in the last pictures, in the next pictures, I will show that this is angle between all the waves is 108. What is the actually the angle of the fourth state of water? What is already know that we are water based, but to see in the Kirlianic and to measure it and to prove that we are actually inside of us, we have the fourth state of water. This is actually amazing. And then we go deep in it. And more the tubules appears. And they go in deep and deep and different kind of fenestrations. See on this part. This actually prove that we are all made from nanotubules, and all those nanotubules catch the different length of light. And how I told you, we are microwave. So different microwaves length in different tubules. And these tubules, when they start to connect with each other, starts to form the spectrum. And this spectrum, when they combine to themselves, they start to solidify, and finally forms the material level of existence. This is so interesting to see, and actually when I met all those investigations, was amazing to see actually how we are made from nanotubules and how all the length of light just length inside the specific tubule, each tubule how connect with different one and make like a switcher, see, and they combine in the bigger nanotubules and connect to each other, and color starts to be different, what means that the different length of light just they mix to each other and starts to be more solidified. It means that they go more to visible light, more solid on this way. Okay, so now it's back to our presentation. Just to show you here is as the picture, see, I just captured different tubules with different fenestrations, and then how they represent with different light, what they mean, the specific microwaves go inside of them. So they form the spectrums, and actually the angles between the nanotubules, they are P1.6. So it's already nice to see that we follow the sacral geometry, and we are able to see inside of analysis of our Kirlianic photography. And that is the angle what I told you, inside of the fingertip Kirlianic. And then I made more interesting investigation with the Biofield viewer, where we're able to see that we are actually, just 1 second, that we are actually the chamber of sound. So this is analysis of the Biofield viewer pictures of the cancer patients. And I start to analyze the picture and go deep in each part and found out those kind of structures. And they are same what we spoke in advance, that is formation of the fields. And they represent themselves as magnetical, as the electrical, as inertia part, see? And actually, when we have the formation on that side, centrifugal of magnetical part, and like that, and centripetal of the electric part, and plan of inertia, in the cross section, this is the cross. And actually the main symbol and the main figure of our universe is the cross. The spatial and contraspatial formation, this is the cross, because the electric and magnetic part, they form the shapes what they mirror each other. Okay, here we go. Here it's so visible. How form is it like semantic shapes. See, upon the semantic shapes, even here it's more visible. It starts to make the waves, see, on this side. And actually, because the human body is made from fields and attracts the same fields and also repulses the fields to a woman. So it acts like a resonance chamber to the environment. See, here it's more visible. This is the inertia part, is vector equilibrium. There is the formation of the magnetical torus and the dielectrical part in our body. So we emit fields, we emit sounds, also we are able, like a semantical bank, to accept the sound. And this is, how to say, to prove that we are not only the material level banks, we are the color banks, we are the light banks, we are the sound banks. We have a consciousness what represents in us like a light, sound, matter, and it's regarding in which one evolvement we are, we be representing our fields in different way. So then this is actually the picture, and if you analyze this picture, you see the perfect golden ratio in it. So from everything what we say, that we are able to find out in different sources and with different investigations that we are made from nanotubes, like a matrix based on carbon 60, and then with these nanotubes, because they have a different penetration, different shape, different length, attract different kind of microwave, and this microwave is probably more than 27, just 27 be proven in analyzed, like tissue cells, starts the formation of the more complex fields combination, and then the cells, the organs, the systems, and all the body. Different interesting things when I use it, the biofield viewer, this is analyzation of the tongue diagnosis, and see, and here where this is the red part, this is actually the stomach, and then the sinuses, and actually this young boy have the inflammation of sinuses. And then when I make a 3D visualization, see, is up like a pillar on this side. Next interesting thing when I use it, this is analysis of the MRI pictures. Because I asked myself, when I analyze the cancer patient and they come to me with a PET scanner and with MRI, how I'm able to recognize if the picture show the active cancer or showing the necrosis of the tissue, because the starting process of healing around the necrotic area. Because in MRI and PET scanner, the inflammation and necrosis shows up in the same way. And then I started to analyze the MRI pictures with the Biofield viewer. And mostly of you know that the Biofield viewer is the real-time video imaging system. And what is interesting that have different kind of mods Biofield viewer. And with different kind of mods, we are able to see the standard more than 256 level of contrast. What is more important when we analyze the pictures, because in the MRI and PET scanner, we are limited in pixel visualization, and Biofield viewer give us specific spatial resolution. Fields of view, it's 1 trillion vortex voxels and 2 billion pixels. High plan spatial resolution. Color map diapason is more than 1000. High temporal resolution and real-time video imaging. And how this related with MRI? So you see that with Biofield, we have more than 31.6 pixels than MRI and 7.9 pixels more than PET scanner. So, and then if you combine the MRI and Biofield, we're reaching the so high level of visualization. If we combine the PET scanner and the Biofield also. Okay, so here we get just resolution, what we have in MRI, when we add the Biofield, so we have the combined resolution of both of methods. I just briefly will show you. For example, this is the nasopharyngeal carcinoma. This is MRI picture. And in that area, you see just the nasopharyngeal carcinoma place when been, and if it is still carcinoma or necrotic, and the healing process, the pain process with the MRI, we are not able to recognize. So when we use the Biofield viewer above the MRI pictures, we are able to see that we have necrotic area just in small places. Here is the dark blue. And around each necrotic places, we form the defense system. It's collection of the cells of the immunity when they start to heal the place. And actually here we have a progress in healing in carcinoma because we have a huge amount of immune system cells, defense cells, where they are on the place. All of that information we are not able to say regarding only MRI. And even the patient wants to treat himself with the standard medicine, it's better on that stage to stop with chemotherapy and take a rest, because this is the time of defense system of the body. If it's go on with the chemotherapy, this is actually the slowdown for the process of healing and lead even to the death of the patient, because stopping the immunity stop all the defense of the system. Okay, here this is the same patient with the different place where was the metastasis. It is the same thing. We are able to analyze where is the necrosis and where is the defense. I just want to show one more. This is the PET scanner. This is also the cancer patient with the cancer of the colon. And here you are able to see this is the metastatic area with the PET scanner and how they look like in the biofield. If you zoom in it each the metastasis area, we are able to see if we have the defense, how it's here, or we have the necrosis. All of this is metastasis. They are zoomed and we see that we have the defense, even the healing process inside of it. And this is the video, how it looks like the metastasis in the PET scanner and how it looks simultaneously in the bioviewer. On that way, you are able to see the active area, even you are able to see how deep they are, how big they are inside of the organ, them 3D volume, how much they are, them length, and how deep they go inside of the certain organ or tissue. So, on that way, we're able to use BioViewer in the certain things and to help not only for ourselves for diagnosis, but also to help to our colleagues in discussion of specific medical cases to orientate themselves where to go, how to go, even when they use the traditional medicine. Because up to the moment, the devices where they're using, there are not so much visibility to understand on the stage of the process. This is the healing, or this is we're not reaching this point. And I recommended to many of my colleagues, and actually we did it a lot of investigations in different cases, and most of the time the biofield with combination of MRI and PET scanner was the benefit for the patient. So with all this my investigations and research, I hope I was helpful for you to understand that invisibility of our reality is big one. And actually we are just watching inside of one small window of visible life, but mostly reality is not only that. Thank you for attention. If you have questions, I will be happy to ask for you and leave the comments below the video. Thank you very much.